There are situations in life which you actively pursue and others which you are pushed into. One such situation where I was literally pushed into was this great Indian ethos called matrimony. As a teenager, I thought my late 20s would be where I would be slithering away to success while carrying my grey laptop in one hand, holding the Women of the Year trophy in another, while wearing the domestic goddess apron with my husband and brood of kids cheering me from the crowd, as well as the millions of women I had saved. Reality, however, refused to keep up on any front. I was the first one to step out of those super uncomfortable shoes, and my man seemed to have gotten lost in the Kumbh Mela, especially the last one. Firstly, the indignity of searching a man, and secondly, on the internet. It didn't help that most of my friends seemed to have found their person on UberShare, on Tinder, in tenants, in class 10 tuitions. The list of serendipity around me seemed to be endless. I fully bought into the soulmate saga, bought out by books, movies, and spiritualists. He's out there, they critically predicted. Obviously, the universe was getting some cheap thrills. There was a time when I had a checklist as stringent as a Howard admit. Sugar and sweet boys, education, grammar, creativity, teetotaler, vegetarian, and the worst offender, a slender nose. Maturity, though, does teach you a few things. These days, my unabashed appreciation is no longer for people with sporting or economic achievements, but those who can manage the cope of a romantic relationship. While I wander the maze like a headless chicken, my relatives provided me unsolicited advice, ranging from matrimony portals, their nephews, to even shaman-like matchmakers. Well, my parents made this matrimony profile, and I stared. How did I even land up in this mess? For the lucky ones who never had to enter the dating minefield. The most early dates usually take place in a coffee shop. They are casual and allow for a quick emergency exit. And thus started the chain of events. So I used to think I did not give much importance to physical proportions. And why should I? Until I met this man. Now this man loved cats. Cats in my world meant children, animals, trees, spirituality. These were sacrosanct to me, and a very rare combination to find in men. However, when every second sentence of his gave a special reference to his mother and sister's private parts, the creepiness clearly outweighed the poor grammar skills. You are instead of your was barely noticed. From zero creativity, calculative, Marwari, chartered accountants, for the record, my dad is a CA, to Tommy Hilfiger screaming from top to bottom. From the ultimate yes men to the ones who wanted a working girl, but only from the comforts of their house. From unbashful salesmen who were out there on the first date to seal the deal, to others who only asked, can you cook? And it sufficed. Clearly, all the education, work experience, and other things could go down the drain. Then there was this special type who would keep meeting you but would be emotionally unavailable. Let me also give a special mention to this special epidemic called mommy virus in the Asian subcontinent. So, you know the symptoms are fatal when you hear things like, my mom puts a lot of restrictions on me. You know, I cannot move overseas because I miss my mom. Before you go, let me tell you, he's 30 plus, not 3. I am all for moms, but when they pretend like their middle-aged sons are still toddlers, it is worrisome for me. A suitor's father even came to meet me at my office. It was super easy to impress my parents. All a guy had to do was bow to them in reverence and ask them about their health. I was even made to undergo a professional photo shoot, like I was going to sit for placements. The heights of it all was when my parents registered my name in a public matrimony event by the Agarwal Samaj, clad in a rather than elaborate salwar kameez, I had to go on stage to embarrassingly introduce myself like a startup pitch to an investor, or worse, a mass recruitment by Infosys for unplaced students. I bogged as I spotted my ex-colleague from the stage, wondering how far was I willing to go for this elusive man? The only advantage of having adults intervene was they actually thought it was okay to ask questions like, how much do you earn? While I had to be subtle like an eagle and get that investigation from his designation and spending habits. Any investigation on a guy's financial health also attracts furious activists, because apparently when you're a modern Indian girl, you lose all right to also prefer a man who's like that. My advice to you, if you think a man 1/10 of your salary is good for you, go ahead. If not, move on. Better shallow than sorry. Well, I think, oddly enough, much of the gallant princes, the serendipity, the life-saving kisses has been the male brain's imagination, be it Hans Christian Andersen, Charles Perrault, or Brothers Grimm. These men have caused unimaginable damage to both the genders. On one hand, they have caused us women to go on a wild goose chase for a man which doesn't exist. And on the other hand, they have betrayed their own species by setting standards that no man would ever hear.
Okay.
Sometimes I wonder, have I already missed that man through a mouse click? Sometimes penniless salesmen may turn out to be multi-billion dollar guys. And sometimes a guy who says good morning may actually have a golden heart. Well, if I was a visionary, I wouldn't be here. But today I do think we need to change the stories we tell our girls. Such as, he was not too good, not too bad. He was average. Armed with a degree, she got herself a job instead of waiting around and got herself a horse called Prince. They lived happily ever after until nappy duties drove them apart. I feel this knowledge and understanding needs to be a part of every growing up girl's kit, along with birds, bees, and sanitary napkins. These 25 cups of coffee have been no less than an epiphany. Empathy and ability is what's most critical. And did I say, I'm not a coffee person. I like my organic tea. Thank you.